You make me stronger.
My name is Desiree Smith. Welcome to all those who are joining us this morning in this Mother's Day edition of our worship service. Today we pause to acknowledge our mothers, all the mothers in our congregation, and by extension, those of you who are joining us via social media. So whether you are a biological mother, a spiritual mother, a stepmother, an adopted mother, a grandmother, or you just mothered somebody else's child, today we salute you, we applaud you, and on behalf of our pastor, Reverend Valin Smith, the church board, and myself, we wish for you a wonderful day. Please know that you are loved, you are appreciated, and may God bless you richly. Please enjoy the rest of the service. God bless you.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining with us in worship. Let us bless the Lord together. Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
As we lift our desire to abide in the praises of your people. So we lift our hands as we lift our hearts, as we offer up the praise unto your name. Think about his love. Think about his love. His goodness. Think about his goodness. His grace. Think about his grace that's brought us through. For as high as the heavens above, so great is the measure of our Father's love.
Proverbs chapter 31, verses 10 through 31. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband does safely trust in her, so that he has no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeketh wool and flax and worketh willingly with her hands. She is like the merchant ships. She bringeth her food from afar. She riseth also while it is yet night, and giveth meat to her household, and a portion to her maidens. She considereth a field, and buyeth it. With the fruit of her hands, she planteth a vineyard. She girdeth her loins with strength, and strengthens her arms. She perceiveth that her merchandise is good. Her candle goeth not out by night. She layeth her hand to the spindle, and her hand holdeth to the staff. She stretches out her hand to the poor, yea, she reaches forth her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of the snow for her household, for all her household are clothed with scarlet. She maketh herself coverings of tapestry. Her clothing is silk and purple. Her husband is known in the gates when he sitteth among the elders of the land. She maketh fine linen and selleth it, and delivereth girdles unto the merchants. Strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She openeth her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. She looketh well to the ways of her household, and eateth not the bread of idleness. Her children arise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praiseth her. Many daughters have done virtuously, but thou excelleth them all. Favor is deceitful, and beauty is vain. But a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hands, and let her own works praise her in the gates.
Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. the name of Jesus. What an awesome God we serve. Indeed, we serve a mighty God. And this morning, I just want to just encourage us with this song. In these unprecedented times that we're in, some of us may be tempted to get discouraged, fearful, and anxious. And especially for us as mothers, even as we celebrate Mother's Day, so many times we are overly concerned about our children, what's going to happen. But I just want to remind us this morning that God is able to take care of our children, even as He's able to take care of us. So be blessed and be encouraged today as I seek to minister this song. Hallelujah. Why should I feel discouraged? And why should the shadows come? Why should my heart be lonely and long for heaven?
Tempted, where
When song gives way to sighing, when hope within me dies, this is what I do. I cling the closer to Him. From fear, He sets me free. Hallelujah. God's eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches. He watches me. So I sing because I'm happy, and I sing because I am free. God's eye is on the Yes, I know. It doesn't matter what comes my way. Yes, I know. Be encouraged today that God is able. Yes, I know. In spite of the storms in my life. Yes, I know. It doesn't matter what seems to be happening. I am convinced that He's able. Yes, I know He watches me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. I truly hope you were blessed by that wonderful ministry in song. Let's now go into the Word of God this morning. And let's hear what the Lord has to say to us on this blessed day, on this blessed Mother's Day. But before we go into the Word, let us pray. Father in heaven, thank you for this new day again. Thank you for the Word that is about to be downloaded, yet uploaded in the lives of individuals, women, men, children, boy, and girl. Lord, allow this Word to just come alive this morning, in the ears and in the spirit of your people, so that they will be the better having heard the Word. Not because of me, God, but because of you and the power of your Word, that your Word testifies about your Word, that it shall not return void when it goes out. So we give you praise and we give you thanks for the conversion that will take place, the conviction that will take place, and the recommitment to you, God, because of the spirit of the Word and the Word being revealed in the hearts of people this morning. Again, let your Word come alive unto us. In your Son's name we pray. Amen. For a few minutes, let us investigate the Word of God together from the book of St. John chapter 19. St. John chapter 19, verse 25 and following reads. Now there stood by the cross of Jesus, his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Cleophas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciples standing by, whom he loved, he saith unto his mother, Woman, behold thy son. Then saith he to the disciple, Behold thy mother. And from that hour, that disciple took her unto his own home. Then saith he, verse 27, to the disciple, Behold thy mother. And from that hour, that disciple took her unto his own home. The word of the Lord. May he continue to have his richest blessing on the very same. The text under investigation this morning is also the occasion on which our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ was crucified. But that is not the only story within the story of the crucifixion. In fact, the overall passage revealed to us that coming up to the crucifixion and during the crucifixion, there were government representatives, there were religious representatives, the elders, the scribes, and the Pharisees. They also had the soldiers who were carrying out their paid responsibility as agents of the state. And then there were the disciples scattered. And there was also the women. And the writer John ensured to include Mary Magdalene, and of course the disciple whom Jesus loved. The mere presence of Mary, the mother of Jesus, at the base of the cross, highlight the very theme of the message this morning, and the simple message and the simple theme which accompanies the message and the theme is simply a mother to the end. Are you a mother to the end? For all the women out there, all mothers out there, are you a mother to the end? And the end can mean when you go home to be with the Lord, or unfortunately, if you have lost a child. This morning I'm here to encourage you. If you are at the point of giving up, do not. This morning I'm here to encourage you. Don't allow the prevailing circumstances tell you to give up on your family, give up on your child. That child may be wayward, but the word of God this morning is saying to us from Mary, be a mother to the end. Mothers need to be there for their child and children on special and non-so-special occasions. Yes, mothers need to be there for their children on the very special and the not-so-special occasion. What are the not-so-special occasions? When you have to go to school because of a bad report, that slip of paper come home to you, please come to the office, we need to discuss matters concerning your child. No parent likes to receive that, especially mothers, because most likely have to take time off from work. Whatever you're doing, even if you are domesticated, meaning that you work from home, you still have to take time to go and represent your child. This morning, the text says to us that Mary was there at the base, at the foot of the cross. All other people were there with various responsibility, but as a mother, she showed up. Blessed is that woman who shows up for her child and children, in spite of their misgiving. The text goes on to say to us that Mary, in terms of presence, was there at the birth of Jesus. Luke chapter 2, verse 15 to 16 gives an account of the whole birth story. We all know by now that Jesus was not born in the posh state of a palace, but he was born in a stable. He was born and placed in a manger with sackcloth, or should I say strips of cloth. The text goes on to say to us in Luke chapter 15, verse 16, that while she was there in that humble position, guess what? She had the visitation of royalty. The wise men came from the east, instructed by God, led by science in terms of a star. And it says something to us mothers that it doesn't matter where your child is born, royalty will come visiting. So therefore, every child born to you and across this world has the potential to attract royalty. But not only that, every child born in this world has an opportunity to be a world changer. Even though sin is in the camp, but the opportunity has been given to you, mother, whether you birth naturally or you adopted, God has given you the opportunity. So do not watch the humble beginnings, watch the finish. So we know that Mary was definitely at the birth of Jesus Christ, right there in that stable. And as I said before, she and all the others witnessed the wise men coming in with gifts, frankincense, myrrh, and gold. So we realize that she was there at the very beginning. Her presence was felt. We also realize in John chapter 2, 1 to 11, Mary was also there when Jesus performed his first public miracle at a wedding in Cana of Galilee. In fact, Mary was the one who instructed the person's there. Say, listen, whatever he tells you, do it. Whatever he tells you, do it. Because she knew something. And even when she spoke to him, he said to her, not disrespectfully, woman, my time has not yet come. Indicating to us that, listen, you may have a gifted child. And the society saying, push, push, push. Send them there, send them there. You know, as a mother, the child may not be ready for that video light, the limelight. And that is why Jesus, even though he was an adult at the time, spoke rebukingly, but spoke with respect to his mother. My time has not yet come. And that's saying to us that as we are there for our children, as parents, especially mothers, we got to know and allow them to go in their way. What did the Bible say? The Bible said, what parents, children, parents, mothers, fathers, grow your children in the way that they should go. So they can't be like the Joneses' children. And they can't be like that other set of people. Grow them in such a way where they are bent, and they are bent towards evil, and you will develop. So she was there at the birth. She was there at his first public miracle. And you may be saying, Pastor, so? What a joy it is to see your son, your child, your daughter, daughters, sons. Probably you have a lawyer. That first case, that graduation. I mean, these things are special to children. And mothers tend to cherish these things. The Bible said, in another part of the Bible, Mary treasured these things in her heart. So mothers, women, be present as best as possible. The Bible goes on to tell us in Mark chapter 3, verse 31 through to 35, Mary was also present. When Jesus established the priority of the kingdom of God. Yes, he established the priority of the kingdom of God over family. When he said to her, not disrespectfully, when the question was posed to him, your mother and your brethren are all there to see you. He said, who is my mother and who is my father? I'm paraphrasing here, but he said, these are the ones. That's my mother, my father. Simply saying that, listen, God has called your child, your children to a particular ministry in the kingdom of God. And listen, God takes priority over family, yet he established family. So we have been given a few amount of years, mothers and parents out there listening. We are given a few number of years to impact our children's life. There comes a time where we let go. Reading it through 21st century mind, Mark chapter 3, verse 31 to 35, we may say Jesus was rude. But remember, on the occasion when they had gone visiting, as they would go for the Passover, and they thought that boy Jesus, at the age of 12, some say 13, was with family. And after a couple of days of searching, they could not find him. And they had to go back to where they were coming from. After a couple of days' journey, the Bible tells us clearly, and they search and they search almost like Google. And the Bible said they found him where? In the temple. Good place to be found. And what was he doing? Stealing internet? No. What was he doing? He was among the bright people. He was among the elders and the teachers and so on, reasoning with them almighty. So we see now that even at that age, he was ready, but he was just biding his time. The Bible said, listen, they found him in the temple. Reasoning among the elders. So I'm saying to you this morning, he had a priority, the kingdom of God over family. And when they asked him, didn't you know we were worried about you, son? Didn't you know that had been my father's house? There's a song penned to that. Next time I'll sing that for you. But the Bible said that he said, listen, didn't you know that had been my father's house? And what that brings out to me, brothers and sisters, is that the way they brought him up, they knew where he would be. How many of us as parents, especially mothers, can say, listen, I know where my child or children currently are. If there is a point of earthquake, if there is a disaster, I know by what I have taught them that they would go to X place and Y place. So if there is a fire, we know the drill. What am I saying? A relationship is developed between parents and children, especially mothers. Why am I emphasizing mothers? In the Caribbean, it is said that the most households are headed by women. I am not lambasting dual parenting, male and female. That is God's ideal, but I'm living in a real world, and I know that a lot of women out there, God bless you, women, you are pulling the weight. You can't be the father. God didn't design you for that. But you are pulling the responsibility role. And I applaud you this morning on this Mother's Day. I applaud you for doing it. But I'm saying to you, try your best to be there on the special occasions and the not so special occasions. So again, we realize she was there at the birth. Luke chapter 2, verse 15 to 16. She was there when he had, or should I say, conducted his first public miracle at the wedding of Cana in Galilee. John chapter 2, verse 11, 1 to 11. And we realize there also, she was there when he not only established the priority of the kingdom of God, but the priority of the kingdom of God over family. And by extension, saying to you and I this morning, if you're a born again child of God, once we are born again children of God, we are part of his family. So if God is calling your child to be a minister, note, the kingdom of God will take priority. Not disrespectfully, but priority. But this morning you're saying, Pastor, I have tried. I have done my best. But you're saying to me, I have sacrificed. I have prayed and I have fasted. I've taken his name to the altar before the Lord, but you're saying to me, I have spent my last. I have put myself almost in debt to ensure that this child, these children, have a better opportunity of grasping life than I did, praying that they avoid making the same mistakes I made. But your child or children did not follow the prescripted path that you outlaid for them. That you tried your best, women, mothers, for them to walk. You prayed. You may not even be a Christian, but your good intent was for your child to do better than you. Sometimes children do not follow the path or the levity of the upright that you had in mind for them. We all know that people are given by God a free choice to make for their own self. I'm saying to you, you tried your best, but every time you hear the news, the child that you had so much hope in, you rocked that child in your arm, you gave them suck from the breast, you had a hope. This will be the next great person from Jamaica, if not great, a valuable contributor to the society that they're living in, here or overseas elsewhere. But instead of being a blessing to society, your child has become a menace to society. What do I do, Pastor? Spare a prayer for the mother of Timothy McVie, the Oklahoma City bomber in 1995, who was executed by lethal injection in 2001. Spare a prayer for that woman, that mother of that man. So many lives were taken on that day when he orchestrated with another man by the name of Nichols the bombing of the federal building. Over 200 lives were lost. Spare a prayer for the mother of Wayne Smith, alias Sandokan, the notorious gunman of the late 1980s. And the list goes on. Spare a prayer. What do you do? The Holy Bible recommends to us, you must trust the Lord. Trust in the Lord with all our heart and lean not to our own understanding. There are some things that are out of our control, and only God can direct you. It's only God can keep you. The Bible said, he will keep you in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed upon him. This morning, I'm recommending to you that you trust God by committing everything to him. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not again to your own understanding. I'm saying to you also, do not embrace the thought that you are a failure. Do not embrace that. If you tried your best, mothers, women, do not embrace the thinking, the thought that you are a failure. If your child did not or do not and is currently showing signs of not going on the path that they should go. Once you have done your best, you have tried your best to be there. Do not embrace the thought of failure. Because the Bible said, especially if you have come to that stage in your life and you have given your heart to the Lord, the Bible said that your sins have been forgotten. Because the Bible said, if we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Yes, you had a notorious past, but God has intervened through the Holy Spirit and you are now a born-again child of God. And though the seed that you planted in your notorious style have now come to fruition and you are saying, whoa, 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 I am saying to you, listen, God has a way of turning things around. Be a mother to the end. What must you embrace? If you're not going to embrace the failure, if you're not going to embrace all the sadness, I am saying to you, embrace life. John 10:10 says, listen, he came to give us life and life more abundantly. In that very same verse, brothers and sisters, the Bible said to us, the devil, the wicked one, Satan, come to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But Jesus came to give life. And life more abundantly. And the same abundant life that the Bible says that you can inherit because of faith by choosing Jesus Christ, your children and your grandchildren and your children's children can also embrace. Mother, you may just be the one in your family to change the direction of the bloodline and the spiritual line by accepting Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. So I'm recommending to you this morning that you embrace life. Life continues. Opportunities present themselves even when in your own household things are not going well. Begin to serve others. I'm asking you this morning, the best way to serve others, the best way to continue and take opportunities of opportunities that life presents itself, I'm saying to you, the best way to do that is also to make a decision for Christ this morning, mothers. Yes, you have been there. You have been there for the children and our child and our ward. But they are making their own decision, especially their adults. Embrace, embrace, embrace. Embrace salvation in Jesus Christ. That is a lasting testimony. Whether it is the end of your life, God forbid, the end of your child's life. That's a wonderful testimony. They can't help but say, Mommy, died a born-again child of God. We examine the text further and we realize that Jesus was dying on the cross and he said to us, woman, behold thy son. I am saying to you this morning from the text, verse 26, that mothers should know the close friends of their children. You can't know all of them, but you got to know the ones that are influencing your child. As much as they reveal. It takes a relationship to know that. You can't just know it so. You got to have a relationship with your child or children, even your adult children. Why am I saying this? Jesus could stood on the cross, literally held up there by nails and so on, and tradition. But I'm saying to you that he could recommend a friend of his to take over the responsibility of motherhood. You know what that does? It is saying to you and I this morning that, listen, some of the friends that our children have, as mothers, can I say that? You may just need their help in the future. If you have a persona that says you run away everybody that your child or children know, you don't embrace their friendships and so on, I'm saying to you that you may be actually erasing out your future by not embracing some of these friends of your children. You got to know, we have to know as parents, especially mothers, we have to know our children's close friends. One of these children, one of these friends may just come to your rescue someday. Verse 27 says to us, Jesus then said, let me read it for us again. verse 27. Then saith he to the disciple, Behold thy mother. And from that hour that disciple took her unto his own home. There's a song that says, I can recommend my God to any man. Jesus was recommending to the disciple that he loved, his mother. Can your children recommend you to someone else to be their mother? I'm not saying you're perfect, but can your children recommend you to their friends as a mother, to society? A letter of recommendation normally ends, I recommend this person to this organization. I recommend this person, a person worthy for consideration. Can you be recommended by your children, mothers, to their friends, to be a mother to them? This morning, the recommendation, according to the text, is saying that it is worthwhile to have this woman, this mother, under your roof. Jesus put his own reputation on the line by recommending his mother to this man. I ask the question one more time. Jesus was fulfilling Old Testament requirement that a child, a boy child, the first boy child, must take care of the mother after the passing of the father. And he was able to recommend to this man, the disciple whom he loved, the Apostle John, Behold thy mother. Can I recommend you? Can you recommend me as a parent? This morning I'm asking a question because some people feel like it has to be something grand. If you are part of the group that is living in regret, there comes a time we must stop. Because being there and celebrating the successes of our children, your children, being able to offer comfort during times of disappointment can only be possible if the children are there, but if you abort, you cannot do that. If we abort, we cannot do that. I'm saying to single mothers out there, I'm saying to persons who are yet to walk the line of being a parent, if you want this kind of celebration for the children that you want to raise, rubbish the idea of abortion. It is wrong, it is sinful, and it creates more hurt than anything else. You're looking at somebody who was told by their, who my mother told me, someone told her to abort me when she conceived. And if she had done that today, I wouldn't be here today. I am saying to somebody this morning, listen, if you want to celebrate, you cannot be there at the end if there's no one there at the beginning because you're aborted. I'm not here to castigate you. If you have done it, seek the forgiveness of God and the counsel that comes from it. Seek also the release of a child's life taken, but don't go there again. Encourage others not to go there. God is good. God loves you. So I'm saying to us, brethren, this morning, embrace the reality of joy. You said to me, Pastor, we have been trying for years and cannot conceive. And we're frustrated. If motherhood only meant those who give birth, then motherhood would not be worth it. You can be a mother to a child you adopt. You can be the mother of someone else's child and your children. Let not society define who you are. Why? Because God's word has defined you already, fearfully and wonderfully. Forgive yourself. Accept the reality. But know the reality is subjected to the God who said, with him, all things are possible. Mother, walk out of that doldrum and step into your destiny of being a woman, a mother, and a mother of me. This morning, your value and self-worth is not tied to your womb. It's tied to God who speaks to you and declares that he fearfully and wonderfully made, designed by him. The Bible said in Ephesians 2 that God has work prepared in advance for us to do his workmanship. be a mother, just be a parent. This morning, God bless you. All across the world, God bless you. Keep doing a wonderful job. It takes a lifetime to be the perfect mother. Thank you, women. Thank you, ladies. For your patience with us. God bless you. Thank you. And by chance, if you are not a mother, who is a born again child of God, you can make this right with the Lord. Repeat after me this prayer. Father in heaven, I admit to you that I am a sinner. I cannot save myself. I have done atrocities. My sinful atrocity of the land of God is not personal to us, Lord and Savior. Change me within as I confess my sins to you. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Enjoy the day, enjoy the week. Let's celebrate in all this. World changes. Be a mother to the end. God bless.
Good morning. This one's for all mothers today. Mommy, I love you. Mommy, I love you for all that you do. I'll kiss you and hug you, cause you love me too. You feed me and need me to teach you to play. So smile, cause I love you on this Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day! Bye!
So much for joining us. We do hope that you are blessed. Please remember to give Mom that special love, that special kiss, and to always embrace her. If you have made a decision to serve Christ, please let us know. Or you can call us or email us for details below.
Unfathomable. They don't have a clue.
Hear them running up your mouth. Don't you be bigger than what people say?
Glory to your name, God.
Hallelujah. Magnificent God.
Jesus name.